Hello everyone, today we'll grow in beautiful single crystals. Crystals can be grown from almost any salt, however, for a better result I suggest using the copper sulfate one. Of course, you may also use an ordinary table salt for growing the crystals. The very first thing you should do before you will start growing a crystal is to make a growing seed. Seed is a small crystal that is immersed in the solution and that will grow there. It should be about the size of a pea. At first, let's take a glass and pour there a third to a half of the amount of a salt. Next, pour some hot water in the cup and stir it all. If you add less, then you will need to keep adding salt until it is no longer dissolvable. After the salt is no longer dissolving and the solution becomes saturated, it must now be filtered to get rid of various impurities. After filtration, add to the bottom of the glass a little copper sulfate and leave the glass for a few days to let the crystals form. After a day or so, you should find at the bottom of the glass that there's a lot of beautiful crystals has been formed. Now we merge the solution into another cup to pick open interlocked crystal mass. Take any knife or any other sharp tool and drill the crystal mass. Once we have scratched it all, pour everything into a bowl. Choose a smooth and large crystal. Also, I advise you not to take the copper off with your bare hands. It's better to do with gloves on. Once we have chosen the large crystal, it must be now tied to a thread. To do this, I come up with an interesting system in which you can conveniently change the height of a crystal. Also with this system, the cup is protected from dust. We hang the crystal to a cup and now all we do is wait. Growing crystal requires a lot of time and patience. When I was doing it before, I was also growing a crystal of a mixture of potassium chloride and sodium chloride, in parallel with making the crystal of copper sulfate. Here's 60% of potassium chloride and the rest of just sodium chloride. If you want to get a very smooth and beautiful single crystal, you'll need to fill the solution every 2 weeks to maintain its cleanness. If the solution is dirty, a crude crystal will grow, and you'll get a polycrystal instead of a single crystal we want. Polycrystal is when a lot of crystals fuse together. Now I'm going to show my crystal grown stages. Sorry, I've not filmed other stages, but anyway. The first week. Second week. Third week. Fourth week, and so on. After 2 months and 1 week, I've decided my crystal was big enough, so I want to stop its growth. And to do that, take off the crystal from the solution and draw the surface using a cloth. Next, you will need to cover the crystal with colorless nail polish. One or two layers is enough. It is necessary to protect the crystal from further destruction. My second crystal mixture of sodium chloride and potassium chloride has grown a node. I am covering its surface with lacquer. After the lacquer has dried, the crystal can be tanked with bare hands. As you can see, the crystals are very beautiful and quite smooth. And now, ladies and gentlemen, as we have done a long journey growing these crystals, let's just enjoy the beautifulness without any further comments.